Welcome back, guys. We're here and we're ready. As soon as I press the button to get ourselves into game number three, Wings Gaming against Complexity. It's one apiece so far. coL won game number one. Wings took game number two. I'm Gareth in the JD Studios here in Berlin, and we're taking you through ESL One Manila 2016. My lovely co-caster Mopax is joining me, as well as game number two. A little bit of a change up in the drafting style here from both teams. Just a little.
Yeah, just barely. Joining us once more will be the Invoker for Wings Gaming. It's the hero that they always tend to prioritize. They love it. Bring it on all the time. They're like, yep, let's just pick Invoker again. But for good reason. Been playing it pretty well. Mid lane didn't go like the best that game, especially considering they had the bounty, but it's an Invoker, so always going to be relevant throughout the whole game. Big target for all those stuns and everything. Provides a little bit of space for the rest of your cores in those fights, and if you don't bring him down, the initial stun, and he unleashes all hell, that's when you get into trouble. But there's that mix-up you're talking about, the fact that the Bounty Hunter is banned out, the Nature's Prophet got banned out instead of this tiny Earth Spirit, and so Complexity will be snagging that up and see if they want to pick up their mid now as well.
And the Phantom Lance of the Puck, something along those lines, to go up against that Invoker. What else could we look at here? A Lion in the first phase is 10 seconds relatively remaining. Uncommon. Could aim towards that one if they really wanted to, but 5 seconds maybe remaining. Even a Swindle's Hero, the Beastmaster at an early stage, wouldn't be awful. We have seen Complexity in the past, though, run the Darkseer Earth Spirit combo and have that as like a dual lane from time to time. You know, Darkseer applies pressure on the bot lane, Earth Spirit rolls in, you find kills off lane and mid, potentially for your little lads. And it will be the Faceless Void, though, not the Darkseer. It is Swindle's Hero.
Yeah, it might be that Wings do pick the Oracle as well. So I don't, and then like they will take it first phase if it's going to be a counter. That could potentially be dissuading them. But yeah, the Faceless Void. So go for the classic offlane pick here. It makes sense when you think about it. Like going into, you have the Earth Spirit, like you have the pressure in the mid lane. The onus in this case isn't really on you to have like a safer mid laner. And so you can kind of hold off. It can be either the Puck, it could be the Queen of Pain, it could be still that PL as well. But Wings heading into this Invoker, this is the Lone Druid. So this is their favorite 1-2, I would say, out of all their drafts. It's going into the Lone Druid, the Invoker. They've done all kinds of different strategies doing this. I've seen, I think this is when they did support Necro. Yeah, it was support Necro with a Lycan. They actually used, kind of just ran at towers. They've got a couple nifty little strats, but this is pretty much like their dream scenario as far as what I've seen from their like Radiant side games.
10 seconds Druid remaining. Invoker. Well, see how things pan out. Even ban the Beastmaster there to Complexity. Radiant, don't want to give away that offlane hero with little boars, because you know you're going to be running this dual lane up towards your safe lane. Now, heroes left still out there. The OD has kind of been ignored this series, but definitely could be picked up again here, or definitely could be picked up here for coL with the Faceless Void Chrono combination, as well as it being pretty good against the Lone Druid. But Wings prioritize the PL ban. We saw how well that did against the Invoker in game number one. Seems they're a little bit worried about how it'll do in this game as well.
Yeah, I think this is boding pretty well for Complexity too, because this means that you can head into your Puck once more for Limp. It's one of his best heroes, signature, when he came into the field. Synergizes fairly well with the Faceless Void, and maybe not actually, because you're lacking a lot of damage. Crystal maybe you leave it. Oh, well, this will help out.
Radiant team pick. A very quick Crystal Maiden pickup there after banning the Shadow Shaman. Is that going to be Hanskin on that one? The 5-roll Crystal Maiden, just jungle a little bit until like level 2 or 3. And then come back out onto the lane to help your safe laner. Earth Spirit's going to be roaming around looking for the mid kills. So we want an active hero for Limp here, right? Something that can output damage and jump onto the Invoker once Earth Spirit rolls in. 10 seconds. What is that hero?
I feel like it'll be Queen. I don't think Puck has enough damage to contribute. But then you're saying, look at the Lone Druid, and you're wondering, do you have to go into like an Ember Spirit or something like that? At least for somebody on the squad. And the other question is, you've already committed to a Faceless Void and an Earth Spirit, so now you've got the issue of trying to beat the Lone Druid. Like, that was one of the more classic ways we saw people deal with... Okay, so it's going to be a Wind Ranger then. Okay, so my brain's just like, It was typically like you had to beat the lone druid to the Radiance, right? You had to like rush down the S towers, make it so that when you finally got it, things went bad. But you opened up with an Earth Spirit and a Faceless Void, so that option's kind of gone for you. So instead, you have to look towards like minus armor strategies or something, some physical damage to actually kill this bear. Because right now, you don't have the heroes to kill this bear.
Or just the
I don't even know if OD's good. Is it OD good enough, do you think?
I think OD is good enough, and it also gives you leeway to move it from safe lane or mid. Because Limp and Chessie can both play that hero. And OD against the Invoker is pretty damn good with the Earth Spirit helping out. It's also pretty damn good safe lane zoning out the off laner. You just leave your options open, I think, with an OD fourth pick
Ten seconds remaining.
Then you've got the Crystal Maiden aura as well. Much mana regen coming out of these heroes. With Crystal Maiden, we often saw like Clink's picks heroes that are very reliant on that mana aura, on the arcane aura. Are there any other heroes that come to mind that really rely on that? Juggernaut mid is one that comes to mind, but with a double melee, Earth Spirit and Faceless Void already set up here, maybe it's a little bit awkward to run that one. I'm not sure.
Other than like Alchemist, you know, that was one of the best ones. Just non-stop acid spray spam. Anyone with that kind of spam, like the PL would have been fantastic, obviously, said. But anyone that loves just like Lina's pretty sick when you have the CM2, just like spamming non-stop Dragon Slaves. Not that I would expect that here. I don't think it's very good with the Wind Ranger.
And then Wings Gaming. Chen, another one of those heroes that has kind of been ignored this series. Left to the wayside, at least for now. Radiant side, so Chen Lion, it's a pretty good combo. You can pair up with a Lone Druid and Invoker to have the Bear and the Forge Spirits and all that thrown out.
Oh, they're going to Venno now.
They're going to Venno?
I think so. My thought would be that like they love this Venomancer. It's something that Wings do. I don't know, maybe they won't, but my only thought was that like if as long as we get like two more Escape Bolt cores, like Ember and like Queen or Ember and even OD or something where it's like a little bit harder to land these Gales and these big spells and the way that the fights kind of come together. Yeah, but Gyro having to like run into the middle of the fights, I feel like this is the exact stomping grounds where they want to pick that hero.
5 seconds.
And they've played it, I want to say they've played it offlane and I believe they even played it safe lane one game.
Reserve
but we'll see. I'd be pretty interested to see it come out. It's just kind of a niche, unique pick for Wings.
The Bananamancer. Oh, let's find out if they go for it. So Gyro here, is that going to be Chessie or Limp? Like, is it mid-Gyro was a thing for Complexity for a long time. But I'm assuming it's just going to be the safe lane Gyrocopter with the Crystal Maiden, and you try and zone people out with Frostbite Rocket Barrage and wait and see what you pick for Limp. You don't really want to be putting Gyro against the Invoker mid. That Forge Spirit tanks up a lot of the Rocket Barrage damage. Even with an Earth Spirit helping out with Boulder Smashes and rolls in onto the Invoker. The Wings, if they do go for the Venno, that means they don't really have a good reactive saving support. The Lion can help and TP out from lane to lane. Maybe look for the old smoke into counter gank. But they did so well with the Dazzle in the previous game, saving people up and making sure Complexity couldn't continue their aggression.
Yeah, they're considering all their options here. I'm really not sure what Complexity's last hero is going to end up being. Do you think? I'm considering the Faceless Void Complexity's position one. But I don't know if that's... I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if Complexity would whip it out. We did see it earlier today, of course. Did you manage to catch that, Navi?
I caught a glimpse of it, yeah.
Disgusting. Quite the build there. We'll assume it's still going to be swindled.
The Wagamama build.
what comes to mind is going for that and then adding like a Slaughter or something for Swindles, where you have that nice minus armor to actually try and do something about this bear, especially with the Doom coming out now as well. But that's an option that's pretty deep into some teams' pockets. I do not have any personal knowledge if that's something that would be coming out here, so who knows? We'll ban the Tide though. Someone to just try and interrupt this Chronosphere and Gyrocopter. Typical Complexity makes me think, just looking at their heroes, I think about the Ember Spirit, but I don't know how it would match up, especially now with this Doom in the pool too, and the Lion as well, and then trying to deal with the Lone Druid.
10 seconds.
It's a little bit spooky, isn't it?
They're in a bit of a pickle, I think.
Wings have, so far, a stronger lineup, laning stage and progressing through. So when they want to push into tier 1s and tier 2s, the Lone Druid, Radiance, because Wings, they run the safe lane, Lone Druid.
5 seconds
most of the time,
remaining.
Don't they?
There's that Queen of Pain ban. They've done both, as far as I'm aware. But it's hard to tell when you can't download replays! Thanks, Valve.
Cheers, Gabe.
Oh, man, this is concerning. I really think the Queen of Pain was, like, the answer that many teams would have looked for there, because you just immediately think of Puck when you think of this escapable mids, but Queen of Pain's the one that lacks the control but adds in the damage, and when you've already rocking this Faceless Void, you're going to be relying on him, and then, of course, Z-Freak, the Master, the Earth Spirit Incarnate, set everything up for you, so... What other heavy damage? I mean, you can still go for the OD, of course. Can't really argue with that. I would still feel comfortable if they want to go that route. Maybe they will do mid and go Klinks again.
Dipping deep into their reserve time. Closing in on 10 seconds remaining now for Complexity.
All right,
for
that's
that
my
final
pick.
Hero. You think Klinks?
Yeah.
Again, it's the Lesh.
Oh, there's some Radiant Complexity gaming. All right. So who's even going to play it? I guess Limp? Or I don't even know who's going to be playing what now. All right, so they've done this combo before, too, with the Treant. Adds in a little bit of their own little Wombo business here.
I mean, they used to level 1 Roshan with the Leshrac last patch, didn't they? But I don't know how well that's going to work out here for them if they wanted to try that in game number 3. And Treant, the final pick there for Wings Gaming. Rounding things out pretty nicely. Just gonna try and keep people held up, but I don't know. In Europe, Treant Protector, you know, you see him maybe go Brown Boots first and run around and Leech Seed people. Otherwise, you go for like the Iron Talon route and farm jungle for the first 5-6 minutes or so.
10 seconds remaining.
I wonder how they run it in China, because it's been a while since I've seen Treant Protector from them. How greedy are you going to be? Because he has been their full role, but he buys career and stuff, so it looks like
he's
going to go for an Orb of Venom, actually. He wants to punch people. Mop Axe is going to be a punching tree. Off lane Lone Druid for Shadow, and a safe lane Doom for Faith Beyond there. And Voker will be heading towards the mid lane, and Innocence on that Treant. Room himself around. Ice has already been scouted. His 2 Observer Wards. That roll from Earth Spirit scouting him out, meaning that the early vision is not going to be there for Wings. Z-Freak made sure of that. Swindles, offlane Void. No Fairy Fires this time. Stout, Tango, Salve. That'll be a Chessie Leshrac with Null Talisman and Tangos, while Limp is being pulled Tangos here for the mid Gyro. And of course, Hanskin Crystal Maiden.
Yeah, that's the way they do her. The classic. But yeah, so the way they usually do this Treant is with the Orb of Venom, he goes into the offlane. And he'll kind of hang around, do like this tree thing business, you know, going invis, punching supports. You can imagine this poor Crystal Maiden. Could be some issues for Hanskin if he gets caught out with a couple right clicks before he can get off that Frostbite. And then he went into the Vlad's Blink the last time they did it.
Well, let's get into things. Game number 3 in this best of 3. Wings Gaming against Complexity. Here for ESL One Manila 2016. This is Group A. Group stage matches playing themselves through. Of course, the main event does start tomorrow. And finishes off on Sunday. You can see already Complexity grouping up for this top rune. They did a lot of running towards bottom and trying to contest it in the previous 2 games. But it looks like they're going to try and play the safe route here, as they've got vision over the high ground from Observer Ward from Z-Freak. Where's the bear? Hiding over in the trees for now. Is that a Nature's Guise level 1?
This is the play, man. Just run around, you punch people, you scout them out.
I mean...
this thing.
He gets a nice ward down, I'll give him that. But no living armor and no leech seed. What is going on? Is he going to try and snipe the courier?
Oh, maybe he is.
He's going to try and snipe the courier. It should be an early-ish bottle here out from the gyro. The build he's gone. Looks like Magic Wand is on the cards for him. Oh, that's a little bear taking a beating out from Z-Freak and Hanskin. Oh, dearie me. Mr. Treant, are you still going to stick around? Nature's Guise, just keep it going. His clarity keeps him topped up on mana as well. Swindles in a 1v2. Doom and Lion up against his face is Void. Gyro against Invoker. And we're looking last hit-wise. The Exhort from Invoker obviously giving him a little bit of an edge in terms of right-click attack damage. Still waiting for this Treant to do something though, Motpax.
I'm going to be so angry if he gets his courier. I totally would have seen this on a replay. Just saying. This would be a very sneaky play. But yeah, it's still just sitting with the Tangos and the Clarity. Both for a Z-Freak, so.
That's
there's the bottle. Oh, it's walking. It's a Walton. Is Hanskin going to go and grab it is the question.
The Treant's gone. The Treant's running away. Trying to leech experience away from the Crystal Maiden, it looks like here, as Hanskin has dipped back into the jungle. Courier, it walks past. The Treant doesn't have a chance anymore, but he might have a chance to punch Hanskin down a little bit with the Orb of Venom. The damage output is pretty good. And Hanskin, he doesn't have mana for the Frostbite just yet. He'll have it in 1 second's time. This will be fine for him. He's got a Fairy Fire. He's trying to bait this one in. Trying to get Innocent's Tree a little bit deeper in here. With the Frostbite back, he sells himself up to full, and Earth Spirits roaming across as well. But now they know the Treant has Nietzsche's guys level 1 and he's popped himself back into invisibility and will be fine. If Treant had only waited 20 seconds longer, maybe even less, 10 seconds longer, he could have found that courier. Makes the long route back to base.
Oh look, he even gets, maybe he won't get it the roll in. Nice.
And the courier! Double clarities on it. That's the Treant's clarity. Z-Freak, he is hunting for this. He wants to kill it.
Oh, there's no way. There's no way they let him get that.
Little Na'Vi weasel.
Oh, it's funny. When we talked about the level 1 Nature's Guise, I just thought to myself, I mean, if he had a jungler, that would make sense, right? But I hadn't considered the fact that Hanskin would actually be that deep doing it. Just Chessie being A-OK on his own, getting some better levels. So, worked out very well for that Treant Protector. Wasn't quite able to snag. Obviously, at the fact that he was scaling the courier and everything, but he didn't end up snagging level 2.
Swindles is being drained all of his mana down a bottom lane. Ice gone for the 1-0-1 build so far. It's a little bit annoying. You can see the adaptation here. Swindles with the time dilation instead of the bash. He's going to go for a bit of that cooldown reduction. A bit of the old slow as well.
Very reminiscent of people talking about Lion being the counter to offlane Doom because he has the low mana pool, but the low mana pool is fine because you have low mana cost. Well, it's the exact same as the new reworked Faceless Void. Very low mana pool, but it doesn't really matter because your time walk is just 40 mana, 50 for time dilation, and even with the early levels into the mana drain, Lion still makes a big dent into that.
Still not rolling it onto meds. I think Z-Freak buy himself a smoke up or something like that soon, because the Radiant Vision is pretty damn good over to this side of the map. They still don't know about this ward though. So Z-Freak thinks that he's hiding in the fog right now, getting ready to roll in. But Swings Invoker knows exactly what's going on right now. While up at top lane, Hanskin still only level 1 on the Treant, so there's no real go in here. Just keeping this Lone Druid for Shadow as safe as he possibly can against the Maiden Leshrac. All this nuke damage, all you need is one Frostbite to set things up, and Chessie just runs towards your bear.
I mean, we're talking nuke damage. I feel like we should point this out in case people haven't seen this before, but this is the Limp special, the classic. This was something that he kind of got renowned for. It's the max missile build, the glorious 1v1 build. It is so frustrating. Look at his HP pool. Boom! There's half your life gone.
And then you've got Z-Freak rolling in as well, who wants to look for this kill. They've got another homing missile, they've got regen on the gyro, level 2 rocket barrage, they just need vision. That's the one thing that they're kind of missing out on at this middle lane for now. Lion's even going to TP in towards mid.
Control. Talk about spam. With the CM aura.
Oh, you're right.
The missile.
Lion's here with a smoke though. He TP'd back onto tier 3 and he's moved himself forward onto this middle lane.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
A little bit passive from both teams right now. They're trying to edge each other out in any way they possibly can, but all these homing missiles coming in, the roll might come through. No, they've got perfect vision of Z-Freak at this point. He walked into the range of the creep wave. Invoker will be fine.
Well, taking a toll, or look at the toll on the last hits though, 30 for Limp. Almost flawless here in the mid lane. And well, only 17 here for our Invoker. So this is the problem with this build, right? It's that transition and moving the next point. I don't even know if he'll go for the last point into the missile. Oh, a smoke? Was he trying to possibly save him as well? No, Ice just leaving. Looks like he's going to try and go partner up with his buddy's top.
He stuck around mid for a long time, thinking the dive was coming. Faith Bian will be up on the high ground, seeing Z-Freak come in. Earth Spirit's having a rough time finding anything, and he has bought himself a smoke, so he has to go and really be a little more sneaky about his movement so far, because Lone Druid has been left alone at top lane. You're looking at Limp's last hits, and fair enough, he's crushing mid. He's doubling up on the Invoker. But this has alleviated a lot of the pressure from the Lone Druid, so Shadow farming through nicely. He's going to have his hand of Midas pretty soon. Oh, Swindle's the bottom lane. Like, okay, he's getting last hits as well. He's a faceless void who's hit level 6. Still a...
Look at the Invoker.
Oh my god, he's behind tier 2. He can't go near the creep wave at this point, because a level 6 gyro, they're going to get the stun and the hex down to Limp. The Sunstrike is good as well. But Limp turns around with a cooldown. Oh, there's the entangle. Through from Shadow. Kills off the Jericho. Look for Shadow now as well. The roll's not going to land onto anyone, but says he's frostbitten up. Still not dead. The stun's going to miss. Hansken retreating out of the close enough to hear from the Invoker, and they'll try, but they will not succeed. And Z-Freak, is there a boulder smash? There's nothing. Still on cooldown with a rolling boulder for 3 seconds as well. But even Chessie TP'd in to rotate onto this lane, but they lose their gyro. It looked like it could be a good turnaround from Complexity, but that just wasn't that snap decision-making.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he just couldn't reach it from the high ground, but going for the Crystal Nova didn't connect on the bear as well, so wasn't able to slow that and try and create that space between it and the gyro. I think the last right click would have came out anyway, unless he went for that frostbite. So losing Limp, obviously, not ideal there. Chessie now coming up here. Will he get rooted is the question. Oh my god, he does!
And Shadow doesn't get stunned with the Earth Spike and Sunstrike not chaining up. Chessie will be glad to leave there with his life, but look at Z-Freak positioning, looking for the kill over onto Shadow. He rolls himself forward. He'll catch Ice Ice instead. Stuns him, kicks him back into Swindles. Where's the Chrono? Swindles aiming for it. Tundalicious down as well, but the Earth Spike is back into Chessie. He'll right click and punch down into Ice Ice. He turns back for Z-Freak, but Shadow's caught in the tree! Hiding in that Chrono. As Treant tries to turn and punch, but Lashrak comes out with a double kill, and Swindles just is not done.
Hit that bash button.
Radiance middle tower. Meanwhile, Invoker dealing with North Korea here. Limp just spamming out these little missiles. Nothing big, don't worry. Just a few little test missiles. But nevertheless, Invoker not having a good time.
No, it's awful, and you never know, like, once the phase boots come out, thankfully they're not there yet, at least for the Invoker's sake, you never know when he's just going to dive you with cooldown. Like, if you stay too close, then you just get cooldown and rock barrage and you die. And there's no safety from this. You do get hit invis, if you guys are wondering, not that it would matter because he's not cross wex, but it was recently changed in case you guys are some old school, because it used to miss on invis, I'm quite certain.
Yeah. There's a bunch of abilities that got changed that way as well, like Phantom Lance used to miss on invis, but now it doesn't. Valve just hates invis heroes. No, gems, dust, sentries, necro 3. How many more items do you need to see invis heroes, honestly? Crystal Maiden down at bottom, 3 in the Crystal Nova. Doom has been left untouched at this bottom lane, and his net worth, 3,300, not the best, not compared to the gyro, but with Scorched Earth up, it's very difficult to kill him. Limp will launch the cooldown onto Faith Bian. He's got a TP scroll and he might just pop this one with a wall stump and salve now coming through. Faith Bian, the homing missiles coming in. The damage output, the frostbite is there. The Sunstrike will not land. And Complexity kill off the Doombringer while Chessie, he's smoked up and wrapping in for this Ice Ice kill on Lion and maybe even a tier 1 tower at bottom.
Yeah, that's the goal. It's time to eliminate this bottom tower. This is the one that if you grab this as dire side, your win rate just like right through the roof. Get down as early as you can. There's a rotation top from Swindle's Chronosphere up in 15 seconds. But it looks like they want more with the smoke. They don't want just the tower. Hoping for a kill here. Can they set anything up, though, Chessie? That range, you can see. Really exhibited depending on Z-Freak.
Yeah, and Invoker just makes himself scarce. Gets the hell out of that middle lane. Phase Aquila for Limp. Chessie with treads. And wondering if Rope of the Magi is going to be drums or if it's going to be a Veil of Discord or something. They've got a hell of a lot of magic damage between the Gyro and the Leshrac. An early Veil for Chessie into a Chrono or something could demolish Wings.
Yeah, I like Veil. I mean, you've got the heavy right clicks of the tree, and you've got the Forge Spirits of the Quas Exord Invoker, you've got the Lone Druid Bear, so all those armor stats as well can be very handy, and they really need everything they can get to burst through. Not just the bear, but... Oh, you got the kill down bottom, but... through the bear, the Treant, and as well as the Doom. High HP pools. Swindles. Oh, they see him? No, no. Yeah, they see him. They see him. Treant's pinging it. Oh, they didn't find him. Swindles, run!
Out he goes. goes.
But meanwhile, Fate's getting this with the Nature's Guise.
Got the Doom
Tricky plays.
The Chrono here to try and save him. Chessie still doomed up, and Limpus walked into Chrono as well. This Leshrac, a couple more swipes and he's dead to rights. The Doom will take him down with the help of the Little Bear, but the turn back onto Faith Bian. The Doom is caught in place and taken out by the Crystal Maiden. The chase is still on though. It's Complexity. I'm not going to be able to catch up here to Wings and Lone Druid. He completed his Hand of Midas now with Ice Ice sticking around looking for that level 6. Invoker got free reign of mid, and the double Midas for Wings could start paying off really soon. Even looking for Swindles with a Sunstrike. Perfect placement again. They know how to chain these really well.
Yeah, and you gotta think, even just that trade of the Doom and the Leshrac can be favoring this side of Wings. Like, Doom, yeah, you gain position when firm, but all he needs is drums, Vlads. He's gonna be extremely relevant. And all those levels, too. Like Scorched Earth, maxed out. So tanky, so difficult to kill. Meanwhile, Shadow just ever closing in on that relic.
And this is the thing, Lone Druid can kind of run at this Leshrac at any given point, as long as he has one person behind him, one entangle into a Sunstrike and a stun, and Chessie just dies straight up. Sub 1000 HP with Strength Shreds on. Not exactly where you want to be sitting right now. Z-Freak will run himself away from the Doombringer, gets him out of there. There's mid lane, looking for this tier 1. I've traded off already. 1500 gold on your Lone Druid after he takes down the top tower, but this Edict build, level 4 in it, Living Armor and Glyph, keeps it alive, and Edict is pretty much done for right now. Half HP, they've got the tower to, but this could be something that Wings look to defend. They've got Innocence here, not level 6 yet, there's no overgrowth, they won't be able to actually initiate into it.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Yeah, it looks like they're going to get away scot-free thanks to that. That could have been a pretty good rallying point here from the side of Wings, and they're going to smoke up right away. Raining Vision not spawning out of here, so Swindles is on the move. Chrono up in 12 seconds. They get their eyes on the prize, the Shadow. Dire Side Vision, they don't actually see him currently, so Swindles... Oh, it looks like he's going to get out of here. Good game sense here. Swindles, oh, he finds him.
Chrono in one, he's got him. Time Dilation's down as well, just trying to wait for the rest of his team to come in. The Chrono finally lands onto the two of them, and the cooldown will be over the top as well. Chessie, right through with a strut. Shadow. Trapped in place, trying to land the Sunstrike down. Swindles.
Nicely done.
Last time walk there. Nice strike.
Oh, the Lion too.
With immense force. Lion and Earth Spirit apparently had a battle down at bottom lane. What was that? Finger of Death? And Magnetize.
Yeah, like they were tangoing.
They traded ultis, but Lion maybe getting the better of that trade with the experience going to him. Swindles. Oh boy. Overgrowth. There's the punch. Leech Seed into Chessie, but Swindles gets himself away. And this Sunstrike, where's it going to land? Where did it land? Look for Swindles on the back end, but he didn't go back for it. He went forward to try and kill off the Treant.
Yeah, Limp seeing all this with this DD rune. He pushes down. I mean, he's going to run into the Invoker here. Oh, man. That could have been pretty bad for Limp, I'd say. I guess Faith is a little bit too far back. Actually capitalized on any sort of a cold snap. I'd be looking at net worth here anyway. We got three out of the top five belonging to Complexity, but the Doom's not far behind, so relatively even. Overall graph just now sloping pretty quickly down towards Complexity, actually, with these towers dropping.
Very quick indeed. And they did get two very big kills up at top, the Doom and Lone Druid. Slowing his relic just a touch. The Sunstrike, though, again, chained up nicely here from Wings as they clear up Hanskin's Crystal Maiden. Complexity. I do go for the Veil on Chessie, and I'm fully behind this. I really like it.
Yeah, especially Max Edict build. So it gonna make sense. Swindles getting beat down here in the mid lane. That is Chrono, obviously not much of a threat. Oh, but they are rapping on him. There's that
Doom.
Is
there. No time walk for you, my friend. And Infernal Blade and maybe a Cold Snap out. Swindles will drop. The TP's coming in from Complexity. It's only Limp. I won't have any kind of rebuttal there. Dire's middle tower is it's actually kind of interesting thinking about it, because Edict is physical damage, right?
No. Oh, yeah, it is, right. Yeah, because it hits the towers.
So he needs the points in lightning, so it's mainly going to be Pulse Nova that gets the value out of the Veil. Because they changed it. It used to be composite damage on Edict. Dire's top
tower it used to be the half and half or whatever.
Yeah, half magic, half physical. I didn't get blocked by stat shield.
Oh, God. So glad that's gone. That
See,
so
I'm not, because I spent 10 bloody years learning and interacting with it, so that was like ingrained in my memory.
They're trying to set up the combo again. Top. Is this gonna reach? No. They're like trying to bait him in with the Baird right here. And he's gonna come for the last hit. They actually might have been able to get it.
Wait, more packs. Swindles. Where are Doom's Swindles. Items?
Swindle's gonna go down here.
Yeah. Good sun strike. Again, chained it up. But more packs, where are Doom's items? Where's Doom's net worth?
That's a great question.
I mean, 7.6k on the bear, I guess you've switched it over so Shadow gets the majority of this farm. He's nearly got his relic done. But the Doom was meant to be safe lane farming with Devour. And he's only got himself drums and brown boots. Not looking great for him. Even the Faceless Void has overtaken him in net worth. I guess Chessie, he's kind of a weak link here for complexity in terms of itemization. Just the Treads Veil still needs to get into Yulsap to BKBs and things like that. I do have a good rush taking lineup though. Oh, the invis from Invoker. Ice Ice. He's waiting patiently for his moment to shine. Chessie will probably just scout out the line in a second, or no he won't. Chessie wants to set up for this Invoker kill, and he might just walk into the same little nook here that Ice Ice is standing in. They're both across from each other, one tree separates them, but Swindles, he'll be the man to maybe tank this gank or spot out Ice Ice. They see the lion, he's all alone, the hex is there. There's no TP score for Ice Ice, and he misses out on the Earth Spike, so Swindles, he's free to just run himself forward, even with his living armor, I'm pretty sure. Lion is absolutely screwed. Nice Z-Freak, good secure. Well done, mate. Good kill. Good hustle. Turned up just at the right time.
Well, the thing is, he's so done his job at this point though, this line. Like, setting up all of these kills. Nice little sun strikes, and obviously the consecutive chain sends is giving all the space to Shadow, who just snagged a free mid-tower, by the way. And has his relic and basically radiance, and it's gonna be about 18 minutes by the time he picks it up. So bottom lane, they're after Fade, he is dusted. Looks like he'll go down. It's about to wear off. Yeah.
Ah, he's done for. He's going for a blade mail, man. Doom is making a blade mail.
It's a good game for it. Pop it off before the chrono.
Make sure it works out.
Yeah, and that high HP pool that we talked about too. Yeah, that's actually an excellent game. Oh man, this is looking pretty rough for complexity. I think this Radiance is just gonna crush him. That Chessie in trouble mid. Sunstrike gonna connect again. This combo is just nasty.
They make it look so easy as well. But the thing is, the placement, the positioning, the movement of these heroes is so perfect that complexity, even with, you know, a little bit of good warding aggressively here, they don't see the heroes entering into their jungle. They've got to pay close attention to where this line is moving. And even Z-Freak is struggling with a bloody Forge Spirits now, taking him down lower and lower. He does have himself Arcane and Urn.
The Treant's having a massive impact this game. Like, look at these wards coming out from the Radiant side. These are almost dewarded like every single game, but all these sentries because this damn Treant, like in these random places, and killing the Doom, killing everyone else. It's not allowing them to actually use their income to try and do their typical dewarding. And that's where these picks from the line are coming from. Knowing where these rotations are, knowing who's alone. It's one of those very subtle differences that the hero's making, but it's very evident when you look at these sentries that were around the map.
When you take a look at the Lone Druid's damage with Alacrity on the Spirit Bearer as well, this guy does an absolute monstrous amount of damage onto these towers. Already taking the tier 2 up at top to about a third of its HP, and now looking for Limp with the Entangle, and straight up again, Limp is dead! A mega kill streak from Wings, and they are very good at doing this, pulling off another kill at bottom lane. Treant tanking up against the little creeps there, and a good silence back from Z-Freak. That geomagnetic grip will secure that, but it's up at top lane. Swindles with Hanskin. Shadow's dropping low to kill him off as well. Ice Ice, he's going to miss the stun. Swindles dodges past it. Dancing like an absolute ballerina on this Faceless Void. The trade-off is there. 3-for-2 exchange, but complexity, I'm not sure they can really call that a fair one.
Yeah, they certainly come out, you know, the net worth, but 1,000 gold under your Crystal Maiden, not exactly ideal. And the other problem is that that's another 100, well, maybe 80 seconds at this point for Swindles before he has another chrono. So Wings can just step right back on the gas, go for more of these little ganks, these combos, maybe even like a tower push, because I think they want to fight now. They have this Blade Mail, they have their Invoker, he's got the bots, the Midas, he's working up right into that Aghanim Scepter. And not too far away from it at this point as well.
It's been such an easy game for the Invoker as well. His 5-0-2 had, you know, pressure applied to him in the early stages by the homing missile, but that was like a mosquito just biting at him. It's annoying, but didn't really do too much. They didn't have any combo play. They didn't have anything to go on top of the homing missile when this Invoker run himself back to tier 2 every time. So now he's sitting at this point where he has infinite gold, infinite experience. He's level 13. He's, you know, highest in the game pretty much on everything right now. Then you've got the lone druid who isn't far behind him. And with his radiance.
Look at scouting them out again. It's got a bounty hunter treant player. Keeping an eye on Z Freak. But yeah, like the radiance, he is just getting totally out of control.
So with things ramping up towards wings, with the way that items are going, with the way the map's being controlled, the treant giving vision everywhere, what is, like, what's the best play for complexity? They've got lots of options, but Roshan is one of them. I'm just a little bit worried about them going in there. Where do they go?
Anywhere with an objective is ideal for them. Like Roshan, even if it's a tower push, just somewhere where placing in a sentry, you can get some sort of a choke point where you know where the treant protector is actually going to be. Like Roshan's actually pretty ideal. It's not going to allow the initiation from him just walking in and overgrowthing you. Looks like they're going to set up for it now. But it makes sense, right? Because you're relying on Chrono. If you don't hit a decent Chrono, then you're not going to win an engagement. So what better place to do it than here? Yes, they're scary on the side as well of wings, but I think it's needed right now from complexity. Like at least they're drawing them in. Oh, they're going to lose that sentry though.
They even smoke up on the back end as well.
The wraparound play. Do they know though? This seems like something that might be ready. The tree protector here to try and break it in the front lines.
Got wards and
they're definitely ready for this.
Oh man,
it's deep. It's a deep wrap though. Wings. This isn't the typical one.
They have the invis though, the nature's guys. They're actually pushing forward looking for this, and you're right, the deep wrap on to Shadow. The cooldown will land as well. But there's the Doom back on the chessy. The damage output is limited, but Shadow's still not dead just yet. The Devon Blast Meteor, he's still alive. He's capped through this team fight with Living Armor, finally dropped there. But complexity, they've lost too much. Wings, they will take this fight with Hanska dying as well. The overgrowth of the Swindles, he's got no mana left. He's drained out by Ice Eyes with another stun. Swindles is taken out. Oh, five man wipe. An ultra kill for Zedwise Invoker. Complexity, they didn't know what hit them.
Yeah, great couple plays there from Wings. The Doom coming out right away onto your Lesh. Couldn't get much going out of his mana pool. I don't even think he got the Veil off. And then, of course, that Chrono, like we talked about, has to be a good one. Has to be one that's going to be setting up into multiple of the core heroes. I don't think the Lone Druid's enough. At the very least, they're able to bring him and the Doom down. But it's a five-man wipe, and it's going to end up being a tier 1 tower, and potentially even the Roshan. As not having that Chronosphere, how are they ever going to fight that? It's virtually impossible.
Now, complexity getting further and further behind. Blink on your Invoker. 5k net worth deficit, about 5k experience. Difference as well in favor of Wings. Ice Ice with a Blink on Lion and Z Freak. This Earth Spirit still trying to catch up to his counterparts. And Doom. Blink and Blademail now. Apparently, Motpax, Faith Beyond doesn't like upgrading his boots. In game number one, he was a Tidehunter with, what, drums and brown boots, with Blink, Shiver's Guard, Force Staff. Didn't upgrade his boots. Now he's a Doombringer with Blademail, drums, Blink Dagger. Not upgrading his boots. What? He was playing... what was he playing game two? Was it Beastmaster game two? Jungle Beastmaster, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
He didn't upgrade his boots in that, I'm pretty sure. Brown boots, Necro 3, Blink.
Oh my god, is he doing it again? This Lion, dude. Ice, ice.
He's still
such a player.
Kept alive with the Living Armor. The stuns were good, but not good enough. He tried.
I mean, it's admirable either way. Might not have been enough damage, though. I mean, is he level 11? Oh, he's level 12.
Oh, Jesse. And damage here from the Invoker. There's no Aegis though, and Swindles with a good two-man Chrono down. Time dilation is out as well, and Faith Beyond dropping low with a good Volt Smash across the two of them as well. Magnetize is dropped here, and Invoker is dropping very low. And with this freezing field from Hansken, trying to zone the rest of them out. ZY. Oh, he is gone. The Godlike streak taken by Z-Freak. Shadow and Innocence on the back end as well. Limp striping through here. Shadow. This is Wing's turn to get wiped. Complexity only lose.
What?
Chessy. And that one aggressive play they make into the hands of Swindle Malones. That Chrono set things up perfectly for Complexity to run straight on through them, and here's a Roshan for them.
So is this just Wings not capitalizing on what they were given in terms of like winning that fight and not going for anything themselves? And then suddenly Like, I don't even know how that got turned around into a five-man wipe. Everyone just kind of doing the old walk-in, one-by-one kind of a situation. The overgrowth was held to the very last second, trying to save out that lone druid. You had, like, and it actually didn't even set out that well. Like, the chrono wasn't ideal, obviously, because it was, like, a kind of a catch as Chessie just dies. Hanskin came up without even enough mana to use the Risen Field. He just stand there for, like, 3 seconds, just, like, pressing R. You could see him, like, in the perfect spot, just not even moving. By the time he got up, he barely even did anything. But Zephyr with that first initial chase down to bring down the Invoker. Very solid play there. They'll snag up that Aegis, gonna throw it on top of Limp. He's got the Mantis style first. Help him out, you know, up against this Doom. Pop that thing, of course, the Treant. Obviously the other big one for the Entangle.
Did we touch on Hanskin's Midas?
No, we didn't. I just spotted it as well when they were rushing.
It was that
1100 gold that he had.
He bought it like a while ago, like 7 minutes ago, 8 minutes ago. Like, he bought it pre 20 minutes, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, it was after that fight top. It was up here when he ended up getting all the bounty from killing the lone druid, I think it was. And he ended up with like 1100 gold. So at that point, it's a crystal maiden. Makes sense.
Well, BKB finally up for Limp Manta. Black King Bar, magic community is there. Up against this Invoker who has Ags, Blink, and Boots of Travel. And he's throwing these four spirits out, looking to push out this bottom lane. Lone Druid maybe stalled a little bit in his farm progression. 27 minutes in, he was looking super hot. Currently slowed down a touch with just Vlad's and Radiance. No Hyperstone, no build up into the Assault Cuirass. But Ice Ice Lion, he's 1-6-8. But that score, it doesn't compare to the impact this line has had.
Did you catch a little dust there from Swindles?
No.
They were just like running through. It's like running through the jungle. Swindles just suddenly time walks and dusts. Just like hoping. Sensed it. His spidey sense was tingling, but he was incorrect.
He felt the trip.
Ooh. The rod for Chessie. Bottom tower is under attack. Oh. Alright. Kind of see it every now and again up against the bear.
Tanks him up a bit. Missed chance.
What is Innocence building?
What's he got? Aether Lens.
No. Can't be that.
It's got to be. Like, what else? What else do you buy on a Treant with a Ring of Health? Crimson Guard?
I mean, I would guess, like,
Lotus Orb is...
Pipe?
Oh, yeah.
It's got...
But then with Pipe, you go for Cloak first, like 9 times out of 10, right? Swindles, is he going to get comboed here? No, he's not. Time Walk away, and it's perfectly easy to save himself. The rest of Complexity, they are balling it up towards this middle tier 2. Swindles, always been jumped and doomed, and now it looks like he will pay for his insolence. He's taken out by Wings. Roshan, he just gets taken away in 2 minutes' time. Limp maybe wants to try and secure something with this and the DD rune that he's still got for another 10-15 seconds as well. They'll get the tier 2, but I think they have to come back and defend this one. The blitz away from the rest of Wings will send them to safety. And Complexity being dragged around this map, little by little, it's definitely starting to show.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, they have some new aggressive vision, though. So maybe once Swindle's back up, they can capitalize on that one, possibly even the one they have up here. Oh, they see the bear picking up that Hyperstone. Ice Ice gets richer and richer. Oh, they now see a gem as well in the lion. And look where he is roaming.
This Star Observer Ward sees every step of the movement, though.
Oh, they would love that.
Looks like Invoker's trying to build into a Black King bar of his own against this Earth Spirit. And the Gyro. Need to tank yourself off and deal with that magic damage somehow. Blink finally up for Swindles as well. If he can get that perfect initiation onto the back lines here of Wings, maybe try and find the Doom or the Lion or someone that's waiting to try and counter-initiate, then start the fight off nicely for him. Innocence is still in his bottom lane. He's got 1,000 gold, and we're still yet to see exactly what he's buying. But oh, look at this up at top, Swindle. He has 7 seconds until the blink is back up. 5 until he can jump in. He'll go now with a time walk. He doesn't need the blink dagger, and the freezing field on the back end. Hans can immediately stunned and hexed and killed off. He's taken out of the game with a tornado as well. Limp is trying to battle through the bear, but the damage aperture is too great for him. The BKB is doing a good amount, but is it going to be enough? They've found Shadow. They've got the one kill they wanted, but Limp is going to get sunstruck into oblivion by the Invoker. The Aegis Immortal will bring him back to life in a second as Faith Biam trapped in place, and Z-Freak's got his number. Even with the living armor, you cannot sustain through that damage. And once again, Complexity on the back of Swindles, his big chronos. They win another team fight.
Thank you, Core Crystal Maiden. Was that Blinks and Finger, I think, was used on the Crystal Maiden there? So I think you consider your job done. Blink, when your support who presses R.
Blink, Hex, Stun, Finger, Tornado. They needed a lot to bring her
down. I think that works. And then everything else just going, like, running free. Obviously that first big BKB from Limp playing a big part in that fight, and in fact they have the Aegis, but when you're committing all of that on top of the Crystal Maiden and you don't even get off the Doom, I don't think there's any way they can take that. So transition right into the tower, and Chessie's here, so pop that edict, start going to work, and look at that thing drop. Every fight is certainly going to be an objective here for the side of Complexity.
There's no glyph here, but tier 3 is difficult. So actually push up onto. Glyph sticks around up on top lane. Maybe a little bit too long. No, Ice not going to catch him with the blink hex or anything like that. Swindles. Gonna have his Manta Style soon while Hanskin's actually stacking up this nice little ancient camp. Dyer's bottom for the gyro to come back in and clear through. Roshan. The other big objective here for Complexity is a little while. Time is money.
They almost got the Doom. And they do have radiant vision here. Are they gonna go for a smoke plate in there? You'd think with this aggressive vision and the way they position, they might, however, this ward. Not obviously spawning with the Treant. I think it's out of the Doom. So they should know they're safe. You look at Swindles, you know, the squad, and they're grouping up here up top lane. Now they are all scattered out here.
The three cores.
And, yeah, exactly. So you know that's where they want to go. But they also know this from side of Complexity, because they've seen them walking through this ward so many times.
And the two supports are sat mid. Finally, the Forge Spirit will get what it came for, which is Hanskin's freezy projectiles thrown onto it. And it is going to be the pipe. Innocence is buying that on the tree, and so you were correct, Motpax. Well done.
Oh, well, that's good. I was getting very worried. I'd be pretty concerned if he whipped out an Aether Lens. Things would be seriously wrong with this hero if that became a suddenly viable option, I think here. What's our bear gun? Is he getting to the AC? It's getting close.
Well, the BKB's done finally for that Doombringer. Well, this is such an awkward moment for both teams. Complexity, they want to really push forward with this early game aggression that they kind of failed to capitalize on until the last 5-6 minutes or so. Found their break with these big old chronos, but can you always rely on Swindles to hit these? Well, jump forward, and you definitely cannot when he absolutely airballs one. The Doom from Faith Beyond not going to come through. The Savage Roar, though, from Shadow will cancel TP out. Now the Doom onto Swindles. He's caught completely with his pants down. And at this point, you have to stand and accept your fate as Z-Freak and Swindles will both lose their lives. And I don't know if it's a bit of a caster's curse there, but you could see what he was doing. You knew exactly what he was aiming for. The two heroes just offset from the chrono. So unfortunate for Swindles.
Yeah, sometimes you get a little bit greedy. You know, you go for that perfect play. Not that you have much choice. Obviously, you had to go for both of them in that situation. Can't just call one and say it's going to be a good chrono, because the other one's going to shut you out from achieving your goals. So they'll just wander themselves right into the pit. Again, without this Aghanim Scepter build that we've been seeing from Swindles today, it does just mean that, like, you feel so free for that full 100 seconds.
Stunning. Oh, Chessie. There's the Tornado and Ice Wall as well. Sunstrike already landed, and in comes Invoker. Chessie, absolutely shredded. A minute without him, the buybacks, well, the BKBs were popped, but there's no buyback here for the Leshrac on Complexity. They've lost three of their heroes in quick succession, as well as Aegis of the Immortal being picked up by the Lone Druid, who has a full Assault Cuirass and another 1,300 gold saved up and ready to spend.
Dire's middle tower, yeah, momentum. And that West Swinging Complexity's way has completely, you know, kind of flown back the other. It was approaching into that, like, 3-4k lead for them. But we've shot back up to the side for Wings. Still a very close game. Both sides. The key heroes, of course, can end up being your Invoker as he gets bigger and bigger into these items. His BKB, 5,600 gold. Man, he is cash rich right now. Going to that probably Octarine core with the general flow of the game right now. Already has his Blink. That seems to be the most logical item. Unless he wants, like, a... Nah, they already have an AC, so... Yeah, I think it just makes the most sense.
I want to see the efficiency play from him. I want to see him put the Midas on the courier, buy the Octarine Core when he can. Once he has buyback and Octarine Core, which is like 700 gold away. Put the Midas on the courier and then like swap it back and forth just to keep the Midas actually flowing with the gold income. Because you don't need to sell it right now. Perfectly fine, just look at that, dewarding away as well with the gem there. Oh, he's going to sell the Midas. He sells the drums for Octarine. He doesn't have buyback. That's kind of interesting.
Yeah, actually kind of changed my mind on that one. I wonder now, when I look at Complexity's draft, I think, imagine a refresher, because Complexity have a lineup that has to win one team fight. They have 90-second cooldown on Freezing Field, and they have 100-second cooldown on Chronosphere. And those abilities get used, that is their fight. And that seems to be the kind of fight that you want the refresher build instead, right? Where you're just winning that one team fight every time that it matters. And unless Complexity can somehow amass all their units once again and come at you a second time before your refreshes back up, which they can't, just off of one hero's cooldown, assuming a single person dies, then refresher might actually be more value in a game like this, in a lot of ways, especially with a BKB. But obviously, Octarine Core, if the game's gonna be going longer, the efficiency over time of an Octarine Core is insane when you're considering every single spell, every single split push, every single blink. It gets to massive peaks, and then he can just go for the refresher next anyway.
And all of a sudden, it's kind of high ground defensive time here from Complexity. Dealing with Aegis, Living Armor, his Treant. He's got his pipe completed, and now a Sage's Mask is over in his stash for God knows what reason. What could he possibly be buying? A Solar Crest, I guess? Solar Crest is pretty good here. Sunstripe. That wasn't the real Void. You've used your Doom, and that was an illusion. While Swindles is chuckling to himself over in the trees here. My plans, they all worked out. He's actually looking for this Chrono, but he's got no follow through. The rest of his team are smoking up into the Dire Jungle, and probably aiming to come down here and meet up with Swindles. I think the moment has kind of passed. Unless Wings stick around a little bit too long, they'll farm up this little medium camp. Innocence will be able to scout out if he just stays on top of that ramp. He's invis. Limp gets revealed up on the high ground. Faith Beyond pops BKB, tries to manta forward, just Limp, but where's the Chrono? Where's the jump from Swindles? He's on the back end, aiming for the Lone Druid. He catches him alone, but there comes the Doombringer. Trying to look for a target, but Shadow's still dropping low with magic damage group from Chessie. They're taking him down slowly but surely. Aegis still stands up on him, though, and Limp, he is destroyed. This poor little Gyro has nothing left in the wild to call his own. As Wings Gaming, they run rampant through this team fight, one after the other. Swindles left standing still, but Chessie's running out of mana, running out of health as well. And he's stunned up into oblivion, into death, and into their grave. Swindles, you can't even fight against Shadow. This Lone Druid will tear you a new one. Z-Freak tries his best to glimmer cape and get himself back out with a Boulder Smash as well. But they've got Vision. They know he's there. The gem on the line and the Deafening Blast finally through from the Invocable. Secure him a triple kill. Swindles, last man standing. You went for the solo Chrono onto the Lone Druid, but Wings made you pay.
Yeah, we talked about this physical damage, right? Trying to deal with this bear, trying to deal with Doom heading into the later parts of the game, and it looks so much like last game as well, where everything was just relying on one hero. It was the Klinks then, and now it's the Gyrocopter. And all this magic damage from the Crystal Maiden, from the Earth Spirit, it is all lovely, but the HP pools are huge at this point. 2700 on the bear itself. And then if Lone Druid goes in that true form, of course, he gets even tankier, up and around 2k. Even the Invoker with the Octarine Core, 2500. Like, it just makes this build so much more value as well. So all they have to do is just focus him down every single time and get rid of that Gyrocopter. And I look,
like, Swindle's Chrono, that's such a tough one. Because he throws it here, because you're going to get the bear, and he also knows he's cutting off the path of the Invoker who was here. So his blink was on cooldown, he had to wait a little bit before he came in. He kind of threw, like, an awkward meatball, but in the end, it's still not enough if you're only chronoing the lone druid, I think, despite pathways being blocked off, especially when it's just trees.
And it was so back then, and forth for a little bit, but Wings, they've secured themselves 10k net worth lead, 5k experience lead, the lone druid stacked, the invoker is close to 6 slotted. Very close to 6 slotted. And Complexity, their best chance. Now, well, Sea Freak has no chance now.
This can't happen. They need the high ground defense with all five heroes.
Exactly.
And this might have just crumbled the game.
Swindles. He has buyback. Swindles does have buyback, and the Doom popped his BKB as well as his ultimate for that one. But this is so rough for them because what they do now really defines whether they can stay in the game or if they lose the game. Complexity, they defend high ground, or they go for like some really ballsy smoke aggressive play outside of their base to try and stop this, but the raw push just comes straight on through.
Trying to think of a Konski make some sort of an item purchase to make some sort of a play here, but they have both gems on the line. Double vision.
Versus Void does buy back, but look at where Fifthian is standing. The blink away from Swindles sends him to safety. The tier 3 drops, and there's no damage here structurally to the rest of Complexity's base. Invoker trying to get himself further and further away from this stupid little homing missile, and he gets plinked on the backside by that one. Oh, Complexity is scouted. Radiant Observer Ward sees their movement down towards this Rosh Pit area. Roshan's not alive though, they were just kind of securing farm for Limp and getting Chessy that Terrine Core. Illusion.
Oh man, and now the Refresher coming out here. This is so terrifying on this Invoker, he has to get chronoed. There is just no way you're going to win this fight if he's not chronoed. I think that is fair to say. The BKB, it's completely up to Swindles, and he needs to be a chronoed, and at the same time, Hanskin, he needs a BKB. He needs to sell his Midas and buy one, I think, at this point. I don't know how relevant his buyback's going to be, right?
Kind of a one-and-done hero.
Yeah. But there's so many things also just go right through it, right? If he just gets entangled by the Lone Druid, and then, of course, if he gets overgrowthed post-BKB or something by the Train Protector. It has to be that big symphony of skills here from the side of Complexity, and I just, you know, it's so tough. It's going to rely on one of those high ground mistakes from Wings, but they're probably thinking about that much more this game, thanks to the mistake they made previously.
And they have a no-loss strategy here to push lanes. The Spirit Bear is there towards mid, just tanking up creep waves, burning through with the Radiance, and they already pushed out a bottom lane with like four spirits and a bit of help from Lion. Oh, Wings. If only they knew what was on top of this high ground here. Limp. Did he get spotted? He did. He's pinged out. And yep, Chessy on his high ground. He's going to reveal the smoke. Did they have a jump forward? Tornado catches on to two of them with a meatball. Deafening Blast not there. The Chrono's good for Swindles, but he's got no mana left. The magic damage burst from Chessy. He's starting this off, but Invoker, he's just tanking through it all with the BP finally coming through. The Overgrowth is there. The Refresher from ZY. Another Meteor. Another Deafening Blast. Three are dead from coL, looking for the forward on Hanskin, and last man standing, guess who it is? The ultra kill from Wings on that Invoker will only miss out on Swindle's Faceless Void.
19-1-8, and that's, correct me if I'm wrong, all three games, Invoker, first pick for them. This guy, man, he shows off his hero.
Absolutely spectacular from him, and they know there's no buyback on the Void anymore, no buyback on Crystal Maiden. They can guess there's maybe no buyback here for the Leshrac or the Gyro, the way they're not using it and holding on to this for a long time. It'll take down a second lane of Rax here for their troubles as well down on bottom. As Ice, Glimmer caved up, looking aggressively for a play onto anyone he can possibly find. Removing Swindles or Hanskin from this team fight is pretty big for them if they can do it, but they're going to go for the disciplined route. Go for the tier 3 and Rax up a top lane and just secure Mega Creeps here against Complexity. Because coL, they've struggled crossing the river with normal creeps. Going to struggle up against Megas as well. There, Swindles. Down he goes. With the TP coming in from Chessy, Z-Freak is already dropped with the Deafening Blast there. Chessy walks into the ice wall, but yep, he is absolutely rogered. The damage output from Wings is too strong at this point. They push themselves into the enemy base and lip last stand saloon here for him. But a Sunstrike, a beyond godlike invoker, give him the kill on the Crystal Maiden as well, because he bloody deserves it.
I watched this Wings lineup, and it's like a little xylophone of players. Where like throughout the game, each one of them is just like striking that perfect balance, like that moment for them. Like early on, you have the Train Protector scouting everything out, checking out these lanes, and then into that very early phase from like 8 to 15 minutes, the Lion just wandering around, setting up all these kills through the Sunstrike with the Lone Druid. And every single time it was like Earthspike into the Hex, the Sunstrike, and the Lone Druid got like half the kills somehow with the Bear right at the end. And it just helped him build into that Radiance so quickly. Faith, in that mid game, he had so many key dooms on top, mostly just on top of Limp, shutting him down, and Chessie as well, negating so much of that damage. And then, I mean, the Master, the Conductor of everything, of course, as this Invoker, all three games. How many Sunstrikes do you think he missed? Two, I think. I want to say I have count of the entire series. This guy was on fire.
I can't even think of any, so the two that you've got were well spotted.
It's like that dire side shop. He missed the one on Swindles this game.
Yeah, I remember that one.
And I think he missed one bottom during the... Yeah, he missed one bottom right by the Radiant side shop when they were diving the Doom this game.
Absolute spark to brilliance out from that Invoker. Well, that's the series done. Wings, they do win this best of three and progress themselves through. Coming up next, though, eHome against Fnatic. I think we'll be trying to get into it as quickly as possible, but of course, players do have to switch in and out and all of that. So we'll take a little bit of a break here. But as soon as we come back, eHome against Fnatic in a best of three for ESL One Manila 2016. I have been Gareth. Joining me is Mopax. You can check us out on social media. I'll post all the links in the chat. See you in a little bit.